cop suspended using the N-word, being openly racist. Let's put up the picture for a mask. We're going to Cincinnati. A Cincinnati officer's police powers have been suspended after her body cam captured her saying a racial slur while on duty and in uniform. Her name is Rose Valentino. Officer Rose was wearing a body camera and it was recording while she was driving past Western Hills University High School on her way to the District 3 station. The officer turned her lights and sirens to signal for parked cars waiting to pick up students to move on, saying, "You gotta move, effing ridiculous, effing a-holes. Is she gonna effing just sit there?" So she went on and on. And then a black teen pedestrian then flips off Valentino as she is crossing, which sets off the officer, saying, "Oh, I effing hate them so much. God, I hate this effing world." Because a child gave her a hand gesture. There's more. When at the station gate to enter, Officer Valentino mutters under her breath, "Effing N-words." I mean, she's been carrying that one with her since, you know, earlier that day. She said, "I effing hate them." That's what she said. Okay. According to the internal report, Officer Valentino admitted to cursing at drivers who did not move their cars. She said she used the racial slur in reference to a black teen who flipped her off while walking down the sidewalk after school. The internal report says Officer Valentino claimed she had been desensitized to racially offensive language by music and hearing people talk on the street, and frequent exposure had allowed the slur to slip into her vernacular. You know, she's really saying, well, listen here, Captain, I listen to rap music. And that's the reason I felt comfortable saying the N-word. Not racist at all. That's her defense. She's saying it's the music's fault that she's racist. Background on Officer Valentino. She's been an officer with Cincinnati PD since 2008. She trains other officers who recently graduated from the academy. And her supervisor said she was dedicated and that she, and I quote, "does great work." The 14-year veteran has been reprimanded for not turning on her body camera multiple times. And she was one of three officers involved in a lawsuit involving race in November of 2018. The city settled the lawsuit with realtor Jerry Isham and prospective homeowner Anthony Edwards, who said they were illegally detained at a showing in West Price Hill after a retired cop called 911 for a break-in. Court documents show that Officer Valentino escalated the situation by aiming her gun at the two men and putting both of the men in handcuffs. So she has already defunded the police. Okay? They had to pay money because of her actions. In March 2020, let's put up her mugshot. She was in fact convicted by plea of disorderly conduct after pushing and punching two family members and using an umbrella to damage a car while off duty. She was referred to a behavioral health center for anger management and still remains active afterwards. Isn't that something? Okay. So naturally, this is part of the reason why people do not like the police, as I say. No accountability, even though they want everyone else to be held to the highest standard of law in front of them. Interesting. She now is suspended. Okay? There's no criminal act, but you have to investigate the investigator now. You have to see if her racism has in fact caused bias in her arrest. And you already have at least one settlement that we know of that involved her misjudgment based on racial bias. And you allowed her to stay on the force. She has had violence against her own family members, multiple, and you allowed her to stay on the force. At some point, Adrienne, when is this a negligent hire? Or you do not do what you should do and something bad happens and now we can blame the agency?
I'd like to say you're definitely in the negligent hire territory. It's a matter of who can hold you accountable for that negligent hiring. But it definitely seems that this individual is just full of problems, without a doubt. They should not be in a position of authority at all, or even armed with a weapon, especially if they're responding to children this way in terms of feeling they need to use racial slurs, then failing to take accountability. And I don't see why it's so difficult simply to say, yes, I am racist, or I have racial conditioning, and maybe that's something I should work on. But until there's some kind of accountability, and actually maybe law enforcement looks to have people among its ranks who, you know, aren't racist, we're gonna continue to have these problems.
That's right. Once again, it's not just policy, it's culture.